uh-oh, you just opened up your calendar and you realize you have a big important meeting in 5 minutes. No time to prepare, no time to find your notes, you are scrambling. Well, it doesn't have to be this way. So today, I'm going to show you how to always be prepared with Google Calendar. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And let's start out with making sure that you have time to prepare for that next meeting. Now there's a couple of ways in which we can do this. My favorite way is to manually add preparation time in advance of an important meeting or just in front of many of my meetings. So for example, here is a quarterly budget review meeting, and I want to make sure that I have prepared my notes, that I've looked over the agenda in advance, maybe make some last minute corrections before the start of this meeting. So as soon as this meeting is booked, what I am going to do is come up here and book my own prep time. Now, I don't have to give it any fancy name. I can simply call it prep. And of course, I'm not going to have it bleed over into that meeting. I'm going to make it 30 minutes in this case. But now this is blocked off in my calendar. It's something that I can look forward to, but also make sure that I'm not surprised when this event comes around, and making sure that I've got some time built into my day to prepare for this meeting. Now, to make this even easier, I often suggest coming up to your settings and changing your default event time. So in order to do that, we want to click on event settings. And here you can see that my default duration is 60 minutes. That's why it blocked out a full hour at the beginning. But maybe it's going to be easier if I make this 30 minutes. So if I go back to my calendar, and let's say I want to create some prep time for this meeting, once again, I'm going to give it just a simple name, something like prep, and maybe I want to get into the habit of giving it a different color. Maybe I'm going to make it a red color. I could come up here and do the same thing with this one. I'm going to make this a red color just so it stands out, just so it's a little different, knowing that that's not the actual meeting. This is just some built-in time that I have added. Now, an additional way in which we can do this is to go back to our settings and change our default meeting times. Once again, we want to click on General and then come here to Event Settings, and we can tick this box, which changes things to what Google calls speedy meetings. And what this means is that now my default durations are 25 minutes instead of 30. It's 50 minutes instead of a full hour. So 30-minute meetings is 5 minutes earlier, and longer meetings are 10 minutes earlier. Now, it's not going to change anything that already exists on our calendar, but if I go to select a new meeting, and here let's say I'm going to say an hour, it's actually going to put it to 10:50. It's still going to give me, it's going to show me that it's roughly an hour or about an hour, but it's actually going to end at 10:50. Now, I'm not the biggest fan of speedy meetings within Google Calendar because I think so many people are simply used to a full hour or a full 30 minutes, that even if this is what it says in the invitation, people are not necessarily going to stick to. But everyone is different, so you may want to go ahead and make that adjustment as well. Now, in addition to adding preparation time or shortening your default meetings, the second thing that we want to look at is adjusting our notifications and our reminders. Now, if I click on any of these meetings here, you'll see that I have a default reminder of 10 minutes before. That's my default for any new meeting or new event which I create within my Google Calendar. However, we sometimes forget, here I'm going to go ahead and add a new meeting, is that we can change that default reminder. So if I come down here, it's going to notify me 10 minutes before in advance, but maybe this is a extra special meeting and I want to be reminded a day before in advance, or maybe just a full hour rather than a few minutes before in advance. If we go ahead and select more options, we can actually add multiple notifications if we want. So maybe I'm going to keep the default 10 minutes, but I'm going to add a notification and I'm going to say, yeah, let's change that to days, not 11 days, one day out, I want to be notified. But here's the other thing you may want to keep in mind. Remember, this notification will pop up on either your mobile device or here within your desktop browser. What is maybe more effective is if it sends me an email one day out in advance. So now I'm going to get an email reminder, which is going to trigger, oh, yes, I've got to prepare this document, or I need to practice my presentation. Whatever I need to do in advance, this is going to be a lot more effective than simply a small pop-up just a few minutes in advance. Remember, you can customize this for every single one of your meetings, either adjusting the default time or adding other notifications. And also keep in mind, this might be a perfect time to come up to your settings and adjust that default time. Now, unlike adjusting things here within our general calendar, you will need to come down to the specific calendar itself. Now, in my case, I put most of my meetings on Scott's calendar. This is my primary calendar. So within Scott's calendar, I'm going to select event notifications, and here I can adjust what those defaults are. So if I want to extend this time, maybe 30 minutes, maybe I want a 30-minute reminder and a 10-minute reminder. I can do that here. Maybe I want to be notified of something via email in advance. I can do that here as well. So this is a great time to adjust that. If 10 minutes or whatever your default is right now is not enough, or you'd like a secondary reminder, this is a great chance to adjust those settings. Now, an additional problem that many of us can relate to is when we are scrambling to find a meeting agenda, a note, a Zoom link, or other information related to that meeting. Well, don't forget that you can add as much information as you like within the meeting event itself. And it's so much more useful than going to find another application or opening up another tab or opening up another file. Here I am with my new meeting example, and if I go and open things up, I've got three different ways that I like to add information directly to that event, so I can always make sure that I'm prepared. The first one is the easiest, and that is if I just simply add my notes right here in the description. So maybe there's a few talking points I want to bring up during the meeting. Maybe there is an agenda that I want to attach and either share with others or maybe just use for my own notes. I can add them right here as bullet points. So I've got that information when this meeting starts. Now, the second thing we can do is go ahead and attach a file using this link here. Now, by hovering over this Google Drive icon, it says add a Google Drive attachment. And that is true, but don't let it fool you. You can directly upload a file from within this dialog. By default, it's going to show up your recent files from within Google Drive. So maybe this is the file that I want to attach. But if you have not yet added it to your Drive account, you can select upload, and now I can directly go and find that file here on this computer. It is going to upload it to my Drive account, but it's also going to add it as a link as well. In this example, I am going to select this particular doc. I'm going to say insert, and now I've got my outline right here attached to this event. So I don't have to go looking for this. I can continue to update this Google Doc as I go. I can change my notes as I'm preparing throughout the week, and I can know that I've got the updated version right here waiting for me within this event. And then lastly, another way that I like to attach notes here within my calendar event is by getting Google Keep involved. Here on my sidebar, I can open up Google Keep, and I can select take a note. And what you'll notice is before I even start taking the note is that it has created a link to this particular calendar event. You can see that it's called New Meeting, which is what I've called this event here. So I can start taking my notes right here within Google Keep. I can say done, and then I can continue to add notes here, but not always from this window, because I'm more often on the go, perhaps, when I'm thinking about this meeting or when I'm wanting to add more notes or review other things here. So here within Google Keep, I can continue to add and edit my notes, and then I'm just one click away. If I select this link, it's going to open up that meeting. It's going to open up that meeting right here. And then my notes will be visible here on the right-hand side. So it's another convenient way in which you can quickly and easily access your meeting, but also see that connection between your notes. Lastly, I want to share with you a bonus tip so that you can make sure that you don't forget the action items which have come up in the meeting. Let's be honest, it can be very easy to set the meeting and also attend the meeting, but sometimes as soon as that meeting is over, we forget what we were supposed to do, or maybe we needed to assign someone else a particular task. So what I like to do, staying here within the Google Calendar view, is to make use of Google Tasks. And even if you're not using Google Tasks for your task manager, you may want to start using it for meeting follow-up. So for example, I'm going to add a task here, and I'm just going to call this meeting action item, something along those lines. And then maybe under the details is where I can add my notes, I can add my assignments, I can add other things that are due, other things that have maybe come up within that particular meeting. But before I finish here, I want to make sure that I give it a due date. So I'm going to say tomorrow. And because I've added a due date, you've noticed that it has been added to my calendar as a task for tomorrow. Now, if you're not seeing these tasks within your Google Calendar, make sure under your My Calendars menu here on the left-hand side that you have checked the Tasks box. Tasks is kind of like a separate calendar, and you can hide those tasks if you want, but if it is checked, it will appear right here within your calendar. So here, you can continue to keep track of those action items when you would like to revisit them or when maybe several of them are due. And if you need to, you can manually move them as well if you need to push them out further in the week. And just like other tasks, once you've completed these action items, you can mark them completed. You will see them faded out here within your calendar and then continue on with your day. So with just a few small tweaks, you can always be prepared instead of scrambling at the last minute. Now, I would love to know, which of these tips did you find most helpful and will you start using next? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. And if you're wanting to learn even more ways to get more done and enjoy less stress, I recommend you watch one of these videos next. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.